to say that we have a very active democracy today, very vibrant actually, I would say. By vibrant, I mean like when you have a very active set of people, like you should take part in each and every single activity that is happening in the country, be it at the PMO level, be it at the rural level. So whatever that is happening in a very constant way, in a very normal way. I do not take part in the happenings that are happening today in the country, which are taking the law and order situation up to some other level. But if we talk about the normal presumptive part of the Indian, so at this independence, I would like to say that the only time for by the education, like moving up the levels of the people, the health indicators going up. See, whatever that is happening at the criticism side, that is happening at the other end. And you have to criticize, because if you want to grow, you need to criticize. But if you really want to see the change happening, then that is happening now, be it in the education terms, be it in the health terms, or whatever that thing is.
Second question is, how do you see the real change happening?
Well, the change is very constant, I would say. Change is inevitable. It is happening at every second, happening every minute, every like hour of the nation, whatever that is happening in the country. You talk of like Tamil Nadu citizen being fighting for the labor wages, and at the same time you are also talking about a tribal people like coming out of the clutches of the government as well, and about the middlemen as well. So this change is happening in a very positive way. We are not going back, I would suggest. We're going in a very positive form, and in a very like healthy way as well. So wherever that we are landing in the next few years, all that is being decided by the population that we are having today, the very youth population. So if we want to really bring the healthy change, if you want to see ourselves in the club of the developed nations, we need to tap on the potential of them. Only then the real change is going to come.
Next question is, what is today India's stand among the global competition?
Well, global competition, I would suggest that it can be in many terms. Now, if you talk about the defense terms, India is the biggest importer of the defense. Now, if you say that, yes, we have a very active stand in that, then yes. If you talk about United Nations Security Council, if you say that India doesn't have an active seat in that, no. That doesn't matter here actually, but the point is the groups like energy, the groups like BRICS, the groups like European Union, now those all groups are being tabled onto the global platform only in the terms of Indian context and the Asian century, I would say. So by this change and by this thing, if we consider India and both China, if they can play a very active role in the participative democracy, then they both countries are going to have a very active stand. By taking in terms of the India, our each and every sector is going to boom in the global context. And the way our relationships are molding today at the diplomatic level, I would suggest, India is at a healthy hand.
What message would you like to convey to India on its independence?
Well, nearly after 70 years of the independence, if I would suggest that, what is the positive that is coming out of the nation? I would say there are many positives. And on the other hand, if you want to criticize on the negative side as well, see, we do have a very negative side factor as well. But now the point is that what positive do we take in our side of the development? If you talk about the education sector, yes, we do have improved a lot. If you talk about the health sector, we do have improved. If we consider your life just 10 years before of the today's, our parents' lives or our grandparents' lives were not as happy and not as developed as we are. Now we are being the replicates of the WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, and the stuff like this, emails. We can send messages, we can contact. So the world is like a global village today. And India, I would suggest that of this village, is a very active member. And this Independence Day, I would like to tell that the people of the India, like, be confident, be very happy about your stuff. And first of all, like, take pride and courage of being an Indian, first of all. Because if you really want to shine your nation, you cannot shine only by Modi ji describing somewhere that yes, India is something very good. He or she or anywhere of the leader or whosoever is coming into the future at that stage, our civilian population has to take pride in this thing, and then they have to believe that we really want to be developed. Only then we can develop.
Now at the last but not the least, I just want to ask, what do you want to say about your students who are doing IAS under your observation?
Well, I would like to say that civil services is a very healthy part of the democracy, I would suggest. At the highest levels of bureaucracy, if you are involved and you want to do really something for the nation, then first of all, you need to be very active in your approach. You need to be very, I would suggest that proactively you have to determine the character first of all, and then according to the demands of the society. Today it is, you know, reflecting a very wise change. Today there is a concept not only of the academic like successful achievements as well, but only at the other end as well, like we have skills part as well, we have the communication part as well, and then we have to inculcate very literary stuff in a wisdom way. And the way they are going into their spheres, I would say be very like normal, be very happy, be very wise first of all. Never take the burden of this preparation. Like, as there's a very beautiful line there, you study just for the knowledge, not for the jobs or something like that. So don't be panic, I would say. Just be happy about that, whatever that is happening around you. Feel the change and feel the course preparation as well. Everything is going to happen for you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome.